105年外交小尖兵英语种子队选拔活动北区初赛开始。介绍贵宾：外交部公众外交协调会张敬旺专门委员，请大家掌声欢迎。为大家介绍今天北区初赛的五位评审：实践大学应用外语学系陈纯丽教授，国立台湾科技大学应用外语系陈淑娇教授，国立台北大学应用外语系左伟芳教授，中原大学应用外国语文学系李嘉远教授，明传大学应用英语学系麦杰斯教授。现在我们就请主办单位之一的外交部公众外交协调会张敬旺专门委员上台为活动揭开序幕。
各位评审老师各位老师家长还有同学大家好。那个今天外交部派我来这边啊，主要最重要的目的要跟各位评审老师表达感谢，也要跟教育部还有公共电视还有各位同学家长老师的支持表达感谢。外交部和教育部15年来办的这个外交小尖兵的活动，这个是在各个部会里面很少见到两个部会可以合作，然后把一个这个英语演讲比赛办到全台湾这个最大的这个英语演讲比赛之一啊，所以这个成功要跟各位再度的致谢。那么今年这个演讲的比赛的这个主题是这个开启国际视野，拓展青年交流。事实上我们一直都在做这个工作，去年呢我们对不起去年呢我们就跟着外交小尖兵到了这个新加坡、泰国和这个马来西亚参访。那么去年的同学的表现非常令人惊艳，尤其在跟 APEC 这个秘书处对谈的时候，我发现他们简直就是外交官。那么今年呢，我想各位也有机会在比赛之后我们到国外去参访，那希望各位能够跟他们表现一样。每一次啊，我观察你们的这个分数都差不了多少，那不论是获胜或者是没有获胜，各位都是外交小尖兵。那今天呢，我们不在这边多打扰各位的时间让各位多准备，祝各位比赛顺利，谢谢，谢谢大家。
第一队表演题目是 Vision with Action Unifies All， 计时开始。
Recovered from my injury so soon.
Thank you, Belle.
So Ariel, you're a young intern from Taiwan. And why did you come to Real with Bell?
I feel truly honored to provide my support for the refugee team. I want to show that Taiwan is a friend to the world. The players' persistence is what inspires me most.
Wow, this is such a great story. Hey, it's about time now. Let's go for a city tour. Follow me.
Yay!
Let's take a selfie.
Oh, Ariel.
Say cheese.
Wow, nice.
Oh, Belle, you must try some feijoada. It's so good.
What's the feijoada?
I know. It's like loba bang in Taiwan.
Oh, we tried that before, Mima.
Oh, loba bang. I like it.
Stop! How dare you? I'm calling the cops.
Hold on. It's her family photo. She must have reasons.
Hey, she's hurt. Are you okay?
You should go to see a doctor. Why are you doing this? She's a robber.
I'm sorry, but I really need money. My kids have been starving for a week, and my husband was badly injured in a construction site yesterday.
Does he have insurance from his company?
They refused to pay anything. They even threatened to fire my husband. We were so scared.
See? She did this for reasons. In the war, I had to steal from a store to get food for my family. I can't understand how she feels right now.
That's unfair. Jamie.
Me?
You should reveal that to the public.
Of course. I'll get my camera.
Ma'am, don't worry about the money. My team is looking for a local guide. Would you like to help us?
Does that mean you forgive me?
Yeah. Everyone deserves a second chance. We want the world to be a big family.
Oh my God, both these are Miss Angels. Oh, I mean, you are both my angels.
Oh, well, I always try to be an angel. And I hope everyone can be an angel in people's lives as well. Because if we don't do so, the chaos will never stop.
Exactly. That is the only way to heal the world. After all, we are on the same boat. Peace must prevail. That's also Taiwan's global vision. A big family!
We'll see if we have family, yeah. Oh, I mean, you're my family. Would you like to have dinner together?
Sure!
I know where to find the best feijoada.
Did you say so?
Yay!
Where are you going?
We are going for feijoada!
第二队表演题目是 Dear Minister of Education， 计时开始。
Let it go, let it go.
What doing now, Teresa?
Oh, Mom, I'm really tired. Can I take a rest and listen to music? Please.
Of course not. Do you know that our kids are working hard? You have to work harder than everyone else. All you have to do is to study, study.
At the beginning of the class, let's introduce the exchange student this semester.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shelly. I come from Finland.
Hi, Shelly.
Okay, now there are 15 minutes away from the class. Let's do the quiz.
Oh.
Stop complaining. When it comes to living better in the future, you have to be well prepared for every exam so that you can be accepted by the university. which means you must have a prosperous future!
Okay, let's quit!
All right.
Hey!
What should I do? What can I do?
Hey, Teresa! Come on! Why are you so depressed about the test? Take it easy. Don't make yourself so tired all the time.
Oh, but I'm not like you. Just make a little effort, and you can do well every test. Besides, it's going to be a midterm exam next week. I'm going to double my efforts.
Well, okay. Bye.
Bye. Why should I spend my whole time studying? Well, Shelly is able to cope with everything a leisure way. Is that people in Finland are more intelligent? Or because Finland's educational system better? Maybe I should go to Finland to find out the actual answer.
Teresa, let's introduce yourself to your classmates.
Hello, everyone. Nice to meet you. I'm Teresa. I come from Taiwan.
Hi, Teresa.
Hey, Nancy and Vivian, I have some questions. Could you help me?
Sure, go ahead.
Why don't you have an admission test to evaluate ability? While I was studying in Taiwan, students would be divided into classes by their scores.
Well, we won't do that because there's no so-called advanced placement in Finland.
But what if the students, they can't catch up with the schedule that teacher planned?
Then teacher will stop and wait until every student understands what they taught. That's also a reason why we have a small size student in one class.
Wow, that's so different from my country. But I still have one question, which is, why don't we have ranking in our transcripts?
Well, in Finland, we emphasize on learning and collaboration instead of competition.
I see. That's the reason why you won't have too much pressure on studies. Teachers in Taiwan always give us standardized answer and ask us to memorize it to our high grades. That's it. I think I found the answer. Let's go back to Taiwan.
Woohoo!
On grades, we should emulate the successful educational system like Finland.
Yes, Teresa. From the youth exchange activities, I feel that you broaden your global vision, try to find out the solution.
But as a student, what can we do to express our opinion? Let me think.
Ah! We have a good idea!
That is to
write a letter to
Minister of Education to
save us!
Although we are just students,
we still have the chance to change our society as long as we adjust our attitudes. Thank you for your attention.
第三队表演题目是 Embrace the role through love。计时开始。
Welcome to Rio International Airport.
Oh, it's such a long flight from Taiwan to Brazil. But I'm so excited. This is my first time to be an exchange student.
At the school gate.
Finally, it's a day. I'm so nervous. I hope everything will be just fine.
I'm already late. Sorry.
In the classroom. Good morning, students. We have a new student today.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sandy. I'm 16 years old, and I'm from Taiwan. I'm very happy to be here. I'll stay here for a year and hope I have the chance to know more about Brazil and each of you. Thank you.
Very nice, Sandy. Why don't you go sit over there just beside Kevin? Okay, everyone can take a break.
Excuse me, is this a wallet? I think you dropped it when you bumped into me just now.
Yeah, thanks. Sorry about that, I was in a hurry. In return, I'll show you around the school.
That would be great.
This is not acceptable. She can still carry from me. In the cafeteria.
This is the cafeteria. We eat here. I'm going to wash my hands. See you later.
Wanna have lunch together?
I'm gonna eat with my friend. Would you like to?
Not interested.
Hey, what's that?
It's chopstick. We call it kuaizi in Taiwan. We eat with it.
Wow, I've never seen it before. Can you teach me how to use it?
Sure, why not?
Betty, look, is that Kevin? I don't think so. He told me he's gonna eat with his friend. How come he with Sandy?
Thank you, Sandy. Hope you like Brazilian food. See you back in class. Bye.
Okay, bye.
So, teaching someone to learn your culture is draining your energy, huh?
No, I don't think so. Culture exchange is very enjoyable for me.
But you still talk a lot, right? Here, have some water.
Oh!
In the classroom.
Sandy, what happened? Why are you like this?
Nothing.
Here, have my towel. Dry yourself up, or else you're gonna get sick.
Kevin, why are you doing this to me? Can't you see? She's just a foreigner with the fair nose and yellow skin. She even used to stick to it. She's different from us.
Listen to me, Betty. You can't say that to Sandy, although she's different from us. You can't discriminate her because of her appearance and unique culture. We all need to respect the differences between one culture and another.
Why can't you understand me? Why are you into a girl from who knows where?
I'm not into her. I'm into cultural exchange.
Oh, I'm sorry. So the thing between you two is just about cultural exchange. Oh my goodness, I'm really sorry. 3 days later.
Sandy, Betty has something to tell you.
Sandy, I'm sorry for what I've done. Here, this is for you.
Oh, it's very beautiful.
In Brazil, this represents one's sincerity. Please accept my apology.
Thank you, and I forgive you. Also, I got something for you. Chopsticks, 筷子. I will teach you how to use it, and you will learn what cultural exchange truly is.
Thank you!
第四队表演题目是 Beauty and the Beast, 计时开始。
Thanks for watching our show. You're watching Youth Talk, Youth Thought. Today, we have some guests from different parts of Taiwan. Taiwan, and we are going to talk about Guanzhangshou's mask with young generations. Stella, what do you think?
Actually, I'm not familiar with Guanzhangshou, so I do some research. As I know, Guanzhangshou are two Buddhist custodians. It developed from Taipei's Temple Fair, and now it's popular in whole Taiwan.
Your information is correct. So, Janice, what do you think about Guanzhangshou from your own experience?
I have a friend who was dropped out of school a year ago. He told me that the members of Guanzhangshou often have bad behaviors. So Ming said their behavior in real life is quite different from the role they play.
What a bull-headed little girl! Every single part of all culture has its own meaning. I guess I should take her to a new window, or she will live in this kind of unbelievable insane idea all her life. That's horrible.
Together.
Wow, that's cool. You seem like a nice and kind boy. By the way, where am I?
Venus, funny girl.
Oh, I got it. And I think the painting on my face is from the traditional culture Guanzhangshou. They believe that this painting can put God's soul in man's body. Unfortunately, I do not think it is as special as yours.
How come? There must be some special meaning in every culture.
That's not possible. The members of Guanzhangshou are not kind people.
No man is so kind or all evil. People who seem evil could be kind sometimes.
That thinking is quite ridiculous.
Stop! Not this!
Thank you, Yanbai.
I'm just doing what I should do.
Hey, are you okay? Oh, what's wrong with your arms and your face?
I got those when I was young. And, you know, as a young kid, I was reckless.
Oh, I got it.
See, beauty is just skin deep. People who look like bad guys don't always have terrible hearts.
I see.
Culture exists to get people's respect, like the painting on your face. Love your own culture and love yourself.
Hey, wake up!
Okay, now I have a different point of Guanzhangshou. I think that this traditional culture makes people respect God and respect nature. The members of it maybe don't look good, but that isn't the look of their hearts.
The girl understood something, and my job is over. Every culture that exists is not made to be laughed or teased. It must have its own meaning, which is not shown externally. This is what we see in the first impression at surface. And beauty is inside the culture, just like beauty in the beast.
Thanks for watching.
The 5th group performance theme is Journey, 计时开始。
bored. Dad, I'm bored.
Sit down. Can you see I'm working?
He said that he wants me to experience another culture. But the only thing I'm experiencing is boredom. Dad, we have to go out, please.
Not again. Okay, fine. But I have work. Can't wait or just make yourself busy.
I can go by myself. We can even see it from here.
Oh, okay, fine. Here's some money. Go buy yourself some food. Just be back at 9.
What do you want?
She doesn't speak Korean.
Then speak English.
But I don't know English.
Stop whining and help her.
Wait, don't kill me. Here, take my money.
Why is she paying me? Am I a taxi driver?
Maybe. You're useless. Use body language. Leia.
What?
Leia.
Cherry.
Kevin.
You know the hotel? Oh, wait. The key.
Okay.
Let's go. Hey, it's 9 o'clock. Where's my daughter? She's not answering me. Where's my daughter?
Look at that. That's so cool.
Hey, yeah, you. What have you done to my daughter?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. They have been great. They took me back to the hotel.
Hi.
안녕하세요.
He doesn't speak English. How do you communicate with them?
We use body language, and I understood them.
I'm glad that you're okay.
I'm more than okay. I just wanted to go to Korea to shop. I used to think that I couldn't communicate with foreigners.
I was afraid to speak to foreigners.
I was afraid of foreigners because they were different.
Yeah.
You don't have to speak a lot of languages.
Or know about other cultures.
You just have to be willing to try.
To communicate.
In a way that everyone understands. Yeah, but I still think she's cute.
Oh, Kevin!
Thank you.
第六队表演题目是 Transition， 计时开始。
Beautiful day! May, can you go to the chicken coop and gather the eggs for me? Where's batting gas later?
Come on! Who gathers eggs by hand today?
Nowadays, people rely on machinery to collect eggs and feed chickens.
There are even drugs that boost the production of eggs.
May, fast is not always the best.
But we can increase productivity.
Why would you say that? Don't you know of the recent global trend?
Are you talking about Pokemon Go? The truth is that this place is so remote that there are no Pokemon at all. I couldn't catch a single one after downloading the app.
You silly girl. The global training is slow life. Most of us today are consumed with speed. We walk quickly, eat quickly, and talk quickly. We don't even have time to savor our life.
Come on! Slow life can only make us fall behind.
Mom, you're out of fashion. I don't want to listen to your lecture anymore. I want to go ride the bike. Maybe I can find treasure somewhere else.
May, May!
We had a nice chat on the train. I'm surprised that Jiayi Daling is also one of your destinations.
As a backpacker, I would love to see the beauty of nature.
And this is a green town with wetland parks. Also, I like tranquil and slow lifestyle. You know what? This town has been certified as a slow city by Cheetah Slow.
Cheetah Slow?
Yes, it is an international association founded in Italy. It aims to spread the idea of slow life.
Oh, I got it. As for me, I come here mainly for its orchid agriculture. In Holland's Flower Festival this year, orchids were one of the focuses. And here, there are even more kinds of orchids.
I see. Since you're a fan of this town, you might have interest in talking with the locals. I booked the B&B, which is highly recommended by the backpackers. Wanna come with me?
Okay, let's go.
I'm Natasha from Italy. I'm contacting you online. Do you remember?
Sure, I'm expecting you. May, can you set the table for me?
And this is my friend from Holland.
Welcome.
Hey, isn't that an orchid? I've seen one in Holland's Flower Festival. It looks gorgeous.
Yeah, this is Phalaenopsis.
We call it butterfly orchid. It was cultivated by my mom.
Butterfly orchid? What a beautiful name!
I've heard that orchids are hard to raise. So we, the Dutch, used to come a long way to Taiwan to learn the skills of its cultivation.
Well, working here is not as difficult as you expect. Like other kinds of flowers, the orchid has its own growth cycle. As long as you grow it according to its natural course, it can be healthy and beautiful.
Just like humans, if we can live, work and study at the right pace, we also can live healthily and happily. That's just the idea Cheetah Slow wants to promote.
I agree. People nowadays suffer a lot while pursuing speed and productivity. We don't even have enough time to focus on one thing.
Actually, if we can slow down, we'll have time to appreciate the beauty of nature and to savor every moment of our life.
But I think slow life may cause us to fall behind. We won't catch up with the global trend.
Slow food, slow pace, and leisure lifestyle is the trend.
Actually, while you own are valuable, and it is something that helped you to win the Cheetah Slow certification this year.
Yeah, sometimes slow is fast, and less is more. While we slow down, we get the most out of every moment.
I can't believe it. I thought our town was old, simple, and slow. I never realized it's a treasure we should cherish.
The greatest treasure should be found nowhere, but in our daily life.
Isn't it wonderful to see you are following the train of slow life from Italy?
And share the growing tips of orchids with the Dutch. We are closely connected with the world. If possible, I'd like to invite you to go biking with me later to see the orchid blossom.
The theme of the Orchid Festival this year is happiness.
I believe you, young people will be able to experience the happiness as well as the slow flight here and help spread it around the world.
Sounds great! Thank you!
Denmark, an integrated bridge to the multifarious world. 计时开始。
Ladies and gentlemen, we're bound to land at Copenhagen Airport. The local temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. We wish you a pleasant journey.
Finally, we arrive at the airport of Copenhagen.
I'm so excited. We are here in Copenhagen on a study tour for 2 weeks.
Indeed, I can't agree with you more. Denmark is rated as the happiest country in the world. There must be plenty of new stuff for us to discover.
Kathleen, Stephanie.
Hey, look.
Hello, aren't you Kathleen and Stephanie from Taiwan?
Yes, we are.
Nice to meet you. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Terry, and I'm here to take care of you two. Just feel free to ask me if you have any questions.
Nice to meet you too, Terry. Thanks for your kindness.
Let me show you around the city.
Wow, this is Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark. Look at all the buildings here, each of which seems to have a history behind. Aren't we like Hansel and Gretel entering Candy House?
Ha! You two know that Denmark is the hometown of Hans Christian Andersen. Enjoy these historical sights.
Hey, cut out! Watch out! A bike! What's that? A bike?
Oh, are you okay? Sorry for forgetting to remind you. Copenhagen is known as the city of Arnhorse. Bikes are our primary means of transportation, and each bike is equipped with a GPS system.
A bike with GPS? How surprising! In Taiwan, even though we have U-bike, motors and cars are our main transportation.
No wonder the air in the city is so clean. It's so eco-friendly. And it occurs to me that Copenhagen Summit took place here in 2009.
Right. A rather significant meeting discussing the challenge of climate change faced by global citizens. Anyway, enjoy your stay here.
This is Lego.
Hey, Kathleen, look at a toy. It's a dream toy for the kids all over the world.
It looks so exquisite.
Yeah, Lego originated in Denmark. In the past, it was made of wood, but now it is replaced by the plastic, which means our country has entered the age of industrialization.
And the spirit of playing Lego resembles our philosophy of education. No restriction, no boundary.
Right. Have you ever heard of hug? It's a Danish word which means a complete absence of anything annoying. It's pure happiness.
Cool! Could we have that as a souvenir?
Okay, let me take you to your nearby souvenir store and buy it.
Look at that set of interlocking bricks! It looks so nice!
Good evening, may I help you?
How much does it cost?
It's $100.
It's so expensive. To buy or not to buy? That's the question.
Here's the cash. Sorry, we don't accept cash. Our shop is cash free.
You don't? What? That's ridiculous.
Sorry, girls. Don't you know that Denmark has become a cash free state in 2016? All transactions are done electronically.
Indeed. We have already gotten rid of cash and coins. Either you swipe your credit card or use your QR code scanner to pay. The whole process is paperless.
I have no idea that the monetary system has changed so radically. And it's totally beyond our comprehension.
Haha, see my pocket. No wallet, no worries. You have no worry of being robbed.
But we're only young students. We don't have credit cards.
Don't worry about that. See, I finished a transaction.
Terry, our hero!
Come on, boys, come on, girls.
your company these days. Denmark is really a link between Europe and other countries.
It seems that our friendship forms is abounding between Europe and Asia.
I hope both of you enjoy the journey.
You bet. Everything in Denmark, including transportation, education, and economy, gives us another vision of the global world.
You truly impress me so much, since both of you have testified your personal growth in this foreign exchange.
Let's keep in touch in the future and share more things about your culture.
Okay, we will. Keep in touch.
Thank you.
Good for nature, good for you. 计时开始。
Paula and Amanda, I have been expecting the trip for a long time. I will run out of my energy experiencing Taiwan this time.
Me too, Lina. I hope I can try plenty of specialty in the different region of Taiwan during this trip as well.
Awesome!
Yeah.
Hello, girls.
Hi, Monica.
How was your trip so far?
It's fantastic. Taiwan's just like magician.We can always see and experience the different food, people in different regions.
Everything is beyond my description.
Exactly.
Taiwan is such a nice place to have fun and to relax.
Yeah, and I think today we will see more in European nation, right?
I can't wait to visit it now. So glad you have a great time here. And of course, I will show you the plantation later. Don't worry.
Anyway, we do enjoy this trip. Also, we are very impressed with the culture of Taiwan.
Really? Great.Maybe you can share with me later.
We would love to.
Come on.
How amazing. We just saw lots of rice fields, tropical palms on your farm. But as we know, Taiwan isn't a big country and not densely populated. We wonder how you sell those products in Taiwan.
This is a very interesting question. Well,In the beginning, our government helped us to export our products. Then we spent time developing our own marketing strategies.
Sounds cool!
Yeah.
Thanks. So, to promote our products effectively, we organized a group of agriculture production and marketing at the same time.
Awesome! So we can get more details about the group on the internet.
Can we? Surely! After that, we sold them to government-run enterprises, traditional supermarkets,organic stores, and so on.
Organic store? Everything here is organic?
Yes, it's all safe, no chemicals.
As far as I know, it's hard to grow food organically, since it takes much more efforts.
I feel the same way. Many countries nowadays grow crops by using genetic engineering techniques. By doing so, people can spend less time, but harvest more, isn't that right?
I've heard of that.However, according to many scientific consensus, consuming GM foods may lead to long-term health problems. In Taiwan, health is a priority.
I get it. That's why many visitors are willing to come and to experience real life here, like planting vegetables, picking fruits, and milking cows on their own.
So you will come back home to succeed in your parents' business after graduation, right?
Why not?I love life in the country very much, and I also feel honored of having contribution to my homeland, especially in the farming industry in Taiwan.
No offense, but it seems that more and more young people are unwilling to devote themselves to the field you mentioned. What a pity.
I can't agree with you more. In our country, most of us have limited opportunities to do something for our agriculture.Thanks to you, I think we may come to know where to start with.
You are giving us lots of inspiration.
Paula is right. Thank you. Your sharing makes us believe that we can do something great.
The pleasure is all mine. To tell the truth, what I care is not only my family, but the education of our younger generation. We shall never forget where the happiness comes from.
Well, I think it's time for us to grab something to eat.
Oops, sorry.Thanks for reminding me. I've reserved a special restaurant for you. Let's waste no time.
Hooray! Yeah, let's go!
It's my treat today. What else do we need?
Honestly, I don't feel like eating so much for lunch. Maybe we don't have to order so many dishes.
Many? Come on, we've only ordered 8 dishes. And you know what? I'm so hungry that I can eat a horse.
That's not appropriate. What if we can finish them all? And there are lots of leftovers.
Yeah, it's our duty to save Mother Earth, not to waste. There's not enough food in our country.
I share the same opinion with Nina. When I was a little girl, my parents always told me to treasure what we have, as there are numerous people around the world suffering from hunger.
I know what you mean. Food shortage, the global issue.
Taiwan has an array of natural resources, vegetation, and agriculture in particular. So, never take our food for granted.
Hey, why don't we show our respect for the land? Let's take action and reduce food waste today.
Well said, actions be louder than words.
Thank you, girls. Today, I've learned so much from you. We should learn to appreciate what we have before Mother Nature forces us to appreciate what we had. To see globally,
to act locally.
Thank you.
第9队表演题目是 The Mighty Environment， 计时开始。
The year was 2050, and Earth's population had come to depend on a group of teenage superheroes to protect it from the evil.
I am Blaze Runner. I can make fire just across the sky.
I am Terra. Earth, rocks, and plants bow to my will.
I am Stratosphere.I can turn the wind into typhoons.
And I'm Hydronator. Water obeys my every command.
Together, we are the mighty environment.
Come, let us toast our latest victory.
Cheers.
Oh, that's awful. It's just me or has water been getting worse?
Good thing none of us swallowed any of it.
Terra. Did you swallow the water?
I didn't mean to. I don't feel so good.
Come on, Terra. Wake up. Wake up.
This water has been poisoned with pollutants. It has drained her of her power.
What do you mean?
She will not wake up unless we can find some clean water and make her drink it.
But where on earth are we going to find any clean water? There's no more.
For generations, our ancestors have been warning the citizens of the world about polluting Earth's resources. But would they listen?
Calm down.
I will burn everything. There will be nothing left for the humans to exploit.
There was nothing we could do to comfort him. He was determined to solve the problem his way.
Not since the end of the dinosaurs has the Earth seen so much fire.
You got that! There's no more food to eat! People are starving!
Blaze Runner, enough of this!
I dare you to try to stop me.
I will blow you away!
My tsunami of water will smother you!
Thanks to their pollution, your powers are useless against me.
What can we do? All the smoke...It's hard to breathe.
It was indeed a grim situation. We were just teenagers. The adults wouldn't listen to us. So we turned to Earth's youth to help us.
Welcome to Greenpeace Environment.
We hear you are working on a solution to reduce air pollution.
Yeah. Through international cooperation and exchange, we are focusing on renewable energy, capping industrial pollution, and putting our electric cars on the road. But it's been a slow process.
You know, profits and all that.
Would you be able to use that network to reach out to the youth of the world for help?
Sure. We could make a video and post it on social media.
It worked. We got the support from a youth who, in turn, voted for more forward-thinking governments committed to eliminating air pollution.
My power has returned.
Woo! Yes.
But I can't fight Blast Runner alone.
Excuse me.I feel I can help. With your endorsement, we could raise enough money to expand the ocean cleanup array so that we could remove plastic and oil from the oceans.
Doing so would make the water clean enough to wake Terra from her sleep.
Exactly. you could help us help you.
And so we had our solution. With support from countries across Southeast Asia, we were able to get the oceans clean enough to give Terra her power back.
What happened? Where's wastewater?
We explained everything to her, and her heart broke.
I can't believe it.
See for yourself.
I shall not rest until I have avenged Terra.
Shh. We need to stop him.
Terra, you're all right?
Yes, I'm better now.
But how?
By working with us to clean up their environment, the people restore clean water,
and we got our powers back. I'm sorry.
If it wasn't for you, people may have continued polluting the earth until it was too late.
In a way, we all need to thank you for caring so much.
We'll come back to the team, brother. We're happy to be a team again.
Yeah.
Together,
we are the mighty environment.
Thank you for listening.
第十队表演题目是 Expanding Global Vision Through International Volunteer Experience. 计时开始。
拜拜，拜拜。
Hey guys!
Hello!
What are you going to do for this summer vacation? I know I'm going to take a long nap and never wake up.
Come on, Drew. Do something meaningful in your life.I know I'm going to be an international volunteer.
I think the title, international volunteer, will look great on our resume. Which country should we go?
Wait a minute, are we deciding which country we're going?
Aren't we rushing into things?
Rina, don't be absurd, okay? Where else do you think we can accomplish this if it don't go wrong?
Wait, that's
You two are giving me a headache. Let's go home and do it tomorrow.
Fine.
You guys won't believe what happened. On my way home, I met some crazy foreign laborers. It was so scary.
What happened?
Are you okay?
I was walking home, and I saw a bunch of them sitting by the road.
And then?
I started walking faster and faster, and they followed me. I thought they were going to rob me for sure.
Seriously?
Well, it turned out they only want to say hello.
That's a relief, but I know what you're talking about.Every time I pass by lost foreign workers, I'm always afraid they'll kick at me or something. You know,
not me, but I hate it when they block out the street with their meaningless activities.
Stop! All of you, listen to yourselves. How can you be so blind and self-centered?
How dare you? I am going to sacrifice my time, my energy, to become an overseas volunteer.
Ken,
is that self-centered?
Let me put it like this.When you're having that big talk about expanding your global vision, did you really stop and ask yourself the question? Are you more focused on you or the people?
Now if you put it like this, you seem to have the point.
Let me show you something and you'll know what I mean. Come on.
Fine. Hi, Drew.
Hi, Sandy.
Where is Rina?
I don't know. She told her just wait here.
She's late.
I know, but she didn't do like this before.
Over here, this way.
Hi. What are we going to do here?
What is this place? What's that funny dress you're wearing?
Well, this is a sari, a traditional Indian dress. And this is open Sunday activity that 140 holds every weekend.
Well, what? What is it?
It is an NPO group that strives to make the migrant workers an integral and meaningful part of Taiwan. So far, there are 600,000 migrant workers on this island. In terms of the ratio, there's one migrant worker among every 40 Taiwanese, hence the name 140.
I see. Then what about the Open Sunday activity?
We hold a party set on a particular theme based on any culture or tradition. Just like this week, our theme is about India.
Oh, no wonder everyone is dressed in Indian traditional garments. This looks like a lot of fun.
It is. You should totally try this delicious food.
Yes.
Here you go.
Thanks. Yummy. This is really good. I used to think Indian food was not for me, but this experience totally changed my mind.
Oh my gosh, what is that guy doing? Is he taking a bath?
Of course not, silly. This is an Indian migrant worker, Rajan.
Hello, friendly people of Taiwan. I'm preferring the Varuna Yagna. I'm praying to the Hindu god of rain for the bountiful harvest in Taiwan.
Oh, that's very sweet of you, but why?
Ever since I started coming to the 140 school, I have fallen in love with Taiwan even more. I wish all the people here would have a better life.
School? Are you a teacher? What did you teach?
Me? Oh, sometimes I'm a teacher, but sometimes I'm a student. Everyone comes here to share their culture with everyone at the 140 school. It is a place where you can benefit from each other.
Does it mean I could come and share things about Taiwan?
Yes, you can show the day-to-day things of Taiwan. Also, you can get the chance to learn all kinds of language.
Yeah, it is all about sharing the fun around. This way, not only will the migrant workers feel right at home, the participants will be having fun, practical and instant cultural interactions.
So, in this case, we can have actual intercultural exchanges right here in Taiwan.
So now you know what I mean. You don't really have to leave the country. All you have to do is to know where to look. So don't go judging before you really understand them.
Now I get it. I see how foolish I was. There are actually so many again accomplished here in Taiwan. The important thing is have the right mindset.
That's right. We could all expand our global views by working as an international volunteer domestically. So,
what are you waiting for?
Bow.
Thanks for watching.
第11队表演题目是 No Discord, No Concord. 计时开始。
I am glad that I get to study abroad in America. Otherwise, I would never have met Mandy. I've liked her for a long time. But I'm not sure whether she would like me, a boy from Taiwan, since she's from Brazil. Christmas is coming.So I should think of something that I can give her as a Christmas gift. Let me ask the Australian girl, Mandy. Hey, Mandy.
Hey, Hongwei.
Christmas is around the corner, so I want to give Grace a Christmas gift. Could you give me some suggestions?
Let me think about it. I remember Grace said she wanted to buy a new dress.
I see. Then I will buy a purple dress for her. I think purple fits her well.
Sounds great. Let's go buy one.
Okay, let's go. Hey, Grace.
Hi, Hongwei.
Christmas is coming, so I want to give you something. This gift is for you. It took me a lot of time to choose, so I hope you will like it.
Oh! Thank you so much. It's very kind of you. I'm sure I like it. Oh my god! Why would you give me such an insensitive gift? How thoughtless!
Mandy, I thought that Grace would really like the gift that I gave her, but it seemed that she didn't like it at all.She's even upset with me now.
That's strange. Why would she be mad at you for giving her a gift?
Hey, guys, what are you talking about now?
Hongwei gave Grace a Christmas gift, but it seems she didn't like it.
What did Hongwei give Grace?
I gave her this.
I see. Actually, purple means death and mourning in Brazil, so normally we don't give someone a purple dress as a Christmas gift. No wonder she was mad at you.
Understand. Giving people a purple dress is like a taboo for Brazilians.
So I shouldn't have picked a purple dress for her.
Don't worry. I think if you explain to Grace why you gave her an appropriate Christmas gift, she will forgive you.
Okay, let's do it together. Sorry, Grace. I didn't know that purple means death and mourning in Brazil.
Never mind. I shouldn't have been mad at you. I should have realized you wouldn't know the cultures of Brazil.
In fact, I gave you this gift for a special purpose. It's not simply a Christmas gift.
What special purpose?
I've liked you for a long time. Would you like to be my girlfriend?
Really? I like you too. Yes, I'd like to be your girlfriend.
That's great. I'm so happy now. Let's take some photos to celebrate the moment.
Good idea.
Wait a minute. Why did you make this gesture? Don't you know this gesture is a taboo for Brazilians?
Yes, don't you know that? It's a taboo for us Brazilians.
What's wrong with you? I just made a gesture. Do you really need to be angry with me about that?
Calm down. We are not familiar with the cultures of other countries. It's an innocent mistake. So we shouldn't get mad at each other just because of a lack of knowledge of other people's cultures.
I'm sorry. I didn't know that this gesture is a taboo in Brazil. I didn't mean to offend you.
It's okay. You weren't aware of the cultural taboos of Brazil. We shouldn't have been so offended by it.
Out of bros, friendship grows. Now we know more about the cultures of other countries. It's a good lesson about the importance of learning the cultures of other countries.
Yes, we should try harder to learn more about the cultures of other countries. Thank you.
第十二队表演题目是 Building Global Vision Through Youth Exchanges， 计时开始。
Why should I live with these people who look dirty and dangerous?
Let's check in the rooms. Please follow me.
Could you be a little bit faster? I'm exhausted today.
Okay, let's move.
Now, let me introduce to you the schedule for tomorrow. You'll have a brunch around 10:30 in the morning and then take a leisure walk to the beach in the afternoon.
Okay, I'm very looking forward to tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Bye!
La 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 la, what a lovely day!
Hey, Lini! Could you please be quiet? How can you be so happy every day?
Why don't you be upset? Maybe we can dance together.
Sure! That's crazy.
Maybe it's a time to go to bed. Good night, my dear.
Good night, my dear friend. Shut up right now.
The next day. It's time to get up, everyone. We will have the feast for brunch.
Today will be a wonderful day.
Sleezing hot.
Let's go.
Dishes in Taiwanese style. I hope you will like them.
What's this? I don't know either.
There are fork and knife on there. Oh my god, where is that terrible smell come from?
This is Taiwanese traditional snack, stinky tofu.
Yeah, what's this?
What is it made for?
I feel sick.
Is it really edible?
Of course. It is delicious.
delicious. I love it very much.
Maybe we should try new things.
No way!
I don't want it.
Stop, please. Cool down. Why are we arguing with each other? We should be friends.
When people from different cultures behave differently, some may feel puzzled or strange because they do not have those habits.
However, when people lack understanding and respect, it will lead to discrimination, exclusion, and even violence. Thus, mutual understanding is the basis of building good relationship.
Though we are from different countries, we are all members of the Earth. We can see each other as our family members. I run this bed and breakfast because I like to meet people from different cultures. How nice there are varieties amongst us.
In conclusion, we should show our respect and tolerance to people different from us. It can make things work better and create a harmonious world.
Thanks for watching!
第十四队表演题目是 Big Footsteps， 计时开始。
We meet again, my old friend. It's funny, 10 years ago, I would have never thought that I, one day, would be wearing this. It should have been you. But you changed me. You taught me to look further than myself. And see the world. You taught me to set down my pride and my bias. Yet, do you remember how I was like back in Africa? I can still recall it like it was just yesterday. India have to be so hot, man.
3 weeks here in India. Still aren't used to the heat here, huh?
I guess I'll never be. I mean, Taiwan is hot and all, but at least we had AC. There isn't even a single fan in here. I'm only glad I get to leave in just a few more days. So, where are we gonna meet this Dr. Nisara?
Dr. Frank, the lad from Africa, but his name is Frank. Also, he's the host of our volunteer program. So have some respect.
Hey man, whatever.
Some small village named Pare Pare. Oh, there he is.
Oh, hello, doctor.
Don't do that, Dr. Frank.
Welcome, young volunteers. We have some difficult cases to deal with today. One of the worst is a mentally unstable woman. She's...
That's her, drop her.
You, get the tweezers!
What's the problem?
Maggots! They've all chewed up the poor fellow's arm!
Maggots? That's disgusting!
So dig her fresh and pick the maggots out!
Me? No, I can't! I know!
It's smart, man! I'll do it!
There. You're fine now.
Good, lad! Now you finish up here and come help me outside!
Hey, you okay? Michael, how were you so prompt to do something so gruesome? How did you not find her disgusting?
That was disgusting for me also. But what they've been through are a lot worse than anything we can imagine. If you think of it that way, then an upset stomach is a small price to pay. No?
I don't know, Michael. I couldn't even bear to touch her, much less and seeing all these people day after day in such terrible conditions. I don't think I can ever be as selfless as you.
Don't apologize, mate. There's no shame in being afraid. After all, it's only those who are afraid that understand their...
Are you okay?
It's fine that you have to leave. But before you do, would you give me your cap?
What? Do you like Yankees that much?
No, but back in Africa, asking for the possessions of someone means that you see the other as family. It's fine that you're leaving early, but we see the people who have the vision and devotion as family.
I don't think I can ever be as selfless as the rest of this family.
No one's asking you to. But the least you can do is try. Come on.
No, I...
Let's give this another go.
Michael!
It's been a long time since I heard from Michael. I guess I'll make a long distance.
Hello?
Oh, hello. May I speak to Michael McArthur, please?
Who is this, please?
Oh, I'm his friend from India.
I'm sorry, but Mikey passed away from cancer a month ago, right after he came back from India.
What? He has cancer? Then why was he even on that trip?
He wanted to make use of his final days. And that program, that was the last thing on his bucket list.
No, no, no.
Hello?
His final wish was to serve others? Hey, Michael, now I know. I'll never be as selfless as you. I'll never devote as much time and attention, and I'll never see them the same way that you do. But you taught me to try.
One, two.
Thank you.
第十五队表演题目是 The Potluck， 计时开始。
I'm so excited about the potluck party we're going to have later. I invited three of my foreign friends, who are Kyle, Steven, and Leo. I believe that it's going to be an awesome night. Coming. Oh, hi, Kyle. Welcome.
Hi, Gary. Thanks for inviting me. I bought bowls of pork ramen and some sushi.Hope you like that.
Sounds pretty good. You know what? We still get some time. Why don't you help me with the table setting?
Sure.
Looks like we have company. Hello, Leo. Come on in.
Thanks, Gary.
Kyle, this is Leo from Egypt. Leo, this is Kyle from Japan.
Nice to meet you, Leo.
Nice to meet you too, Kyle.
So, how long have you been here?
I've been here for 2 weeks. I plan to go to the Philippines to do some voluntary work, thinking I could stop by and visit the island a little bit. But to be honest with you, the more I went around the island, the more I fell in love with this place.
What makes you love Taiwan so much?
People are polite and hospitable. The well-rounded transportation is so convenient. Plus, the beauty of the natural scenery is beyond description. How about you?What brings you here?
I'm an exchange student in Gary's school, being here for 6 months. I enjoy my life here just like you. Taiwan is richly abundant in history and culture. The living cost is reasonable and most of the time. The society is in peace and order. Life here is colorful and full of possibilities.
Thanks, my friend, for knowing Taiwan so deeply. I didn't realize the uniqueness of Taiwan until I went abroad.
There is a saying in your culture.Most people are blessed without knowing it, isn't it?
You can say that again. I think Steven's not going to be on time. Let's start the party.
All right. So, Leo, try the pork ramen first. Taste it while it's hot.
Oh, okay. Hey, I brought shawarma. It's thin bread with beans and other vegetables in it.
Interesting.
I'll go check my oyster omelette. Help yourselves, guys.
Why did he push the pork ramen away and didn't even try it?
It must be Steven. I'll get the door. Hello, Steven. Come join the party.
Hola, amigo.
Guys, this is Steven from Mexico. He's here for Mandarin summer camp.
Hello, Steven.
Hello, guys. I brought some beef tacos. I hope you enjoy it.
I've got some sushi here. Try some.
What's this? It's raw fish. Is it edible?
Yuck. This is disgusting.
That's enough. Don't you know only the best fish can be eaten raw? If you don't like my food, that's fine. But you shouldn't judge my culture like that. Especially you, Leo. You didn't even touch my ramen. Not even a little.
Yeah, Leo, you didn't eat the taco either. What's your problem?
Oh my, that should be a question I'm asking. We don't eat pork, and we don't give our food with left hand. The atmosphere is so unfriendly. Maybe I should leave.
Well, wait, Leo.
I like you, Gary. You are always open-minded and understanding. But I just can't stand those ill-mannered guys.
I'm ill-mannered? You are the one with all the problems.
He's one with problems? Oh no, you were late and you judged my food. Don't say it like you're so out of this. Okay guys, I have this potluck to let young people like you and me have a better chance to know each other, and then maybe we can work together to make this world a better place to live. Since we're all from different cultural backgrounds, there's got to be something we're not used to. For example, in Steven's culture, being late for a date is a gesture of compliment. The point is, since we're all living in this planet together, we should build global vision through interactions and acceptance. You got a point. Maybe I should be more aware of cultural differences.
And I shouldn't make judgments only through my viewpoint.
Gary, my friend, how come you manage to get along with people from different cultures so well?
Taiwan is full of cultural diversities. Taiwanese tend to live in harmony with each other in spite of those differences. And my experiences as an exchange student make me value the place I come from and to embrace the world as a whole. Come on, guys, we're the hope of the future. Let's dream big. One for all.
And all for one.
Thank you.
第16队表演题目是 I can fly, I can fly around the world. 计时开始。
Chris and her brother Mark are in the living room. Hey, Chris, what's up?
Hey, Mark. I'm fine, thanks.
What's that? It looks amazing.
Well, I'm steering a Kolkata drone.A multi-rotor helicopter lifted and propelled by four rotors. See, it can also make aerial photo by drone camera in the sky.
Gee, it's cool. However, it's a loose bit of a complicated gadget. You must go through a lot of struggle when piloting it for the first time, right?
Yeah, multi-rotor flying definitely has a learning curve. Practice makes perfect. Don't worry, I can make it.You know, I am good at it.
It's cool. Oh, by the way, you are gonna graduate from junior high. Which senior high school do you want to go to for the further study?
Actually, I am fond of airplane and wanna major in it. Is that good?
Well, is that true? Let me see. Guess what? One of my friends now study aircraft maintenance at a vocational high school.I'm sure you do know him. He's John. I can give him a call. He's able to give you some information and advice.
John? I remember that guy. A humble person with medium height. Is that that?
Bingo! You are right. Let's call him.
Ding dong. Hi, Mark.
Hey, John. Welcome to my home.This is my sister, Chris.
Hey, Chris. Long time no see. What's new?
Not much.
I just want you to give me some advice about your airplane maintenance department at your school. You know, I am fond of airplane and want to major in it. Is that good?
You bet. It's difficult to study though. You have to know the aircraft drawing, weight and balance, fuel lines and fittings, materials and processes, curling and corrosion control, math, physics, and so on. That is to say, there's a very high demand and good responsible for an aviation mechanic. But it is exciting to know that you can put a good product flying in the sky. And flying around the world, you can enjoy seeing what you work and a plane living with happy passengers.
Jesus, I love it. That's fantastic. What else?
You know, we also have to learn to check the plane. Do an initial walk around to check for the brakes, tires, and lights. Then get out into the cockpit to check the hydraulics, engine oils. We even get meters and gauges out there to see what the symptoms for the aircraft and even get a little bit more diagnostics by going through the schematics. That's a lot of mechanic things you can learn. Is that what you want?
That's it. You really give me a big hand.
Hey Chris, hey Mark, hey John.
Hey Dad.
Hey Mr. David.
What are you guys doing?
We are talking about the aircraft maintenance.
Oh, I noticed. We know Taiwan economics must depend on more and more skillful technicians, and it must be more globalized. Fortunately, Taiwan vocational education is very good as it is in the world. Take the aviation industry for example. At present, low oil prices and robust demand give it more surging profits. Consequently, it becomes more prosperous and global every day. If you want to maximize your career, travel abroad more and get paid more, you must need a global skill set for pursuing a career like aircraft maintenance.
Believe me, I can fly.
I know that I can fly. To give the best of mine, the heaven in the skies.
Okay. We are vocational high school students. We have dreams.
We want to be international technicians. We want to be globalized. We want to fly in the sky.
Okay. Wow.
Thank you.
第十七队表演题目是 What lies behind the border? 计时开始。
Here, I finally in Tasmania. I'm certainly go hiking, kayaking, and canoe. Let's have you taxi.
Wait a moment. Did you see that? Why is everyone carrying a white bag with words? Coast Bay, Tasmania, Australia's first plastic bag-free town.Are they celebrating something?
Don't you know that? Welcome to the Plastic Bag Free World. Ben Kearney inspired us to take action to save the whales in 2003. We are near national parks. You know, thousands of tourists swarming each day. Kearney recognized the severe problems plastic bag brought to the whales.And urge us to stop giving our plastic bag for 10 years. We have reduced plastic bag usage by 2 million. That's quite an accomplishment.
Does the government force you to do that?
No. All of us do this voluntarily. You know, government sucks.
That's inspiring. The local resident can initiate to help whales. There's something we can do.
And we can have a workshop. France government has asked their people not to use the plastic product. Maybe we can ask France exchange students a link to their daily life to us.
Mentioned, even as a student, we're more and more conscious of the cost.
humans have to pay for using and producing plastic products. You may think this is just a bottle of Coke, but you are not aware the cost we have to pay. So, what's the most controversial oil refinery in Taiwan?
Liuqing.
Yeah, so you must know the student in Xuzhou transferred to other schools, right?
Yeah, sort of. There's something in their urines called TDS, TTT, maybe TTF?
You mean TDGA. TDGA is the main kind of remains of the VCM. And VCM is the main chemical of the plastic-related products, such as this and this. The level of the TDGA in the urine of the student in Xuzhou is more than 3 times higher.
And according to a doctor, the level of TDGA are higher now than before. Everybody, we are the plastic man. Would you want to continue to be a plastic man?
It's not my fault, is it? I'm just a student, a small potato. I can hardly make any difference.
There's something we can do.
Join the Plastic Free Club.
The video conference is a success. Thanks, Celine. Your friend gave us some great ideas.
Trust me on. Glad you liked the idea. Social media websites are the great ways to connect the youth who have the same interest of the issue.
Besides the workshop, we can hold some conference to invite somebody who's dedicated in environmental issues. Like I'm going to invite Ranayana, who had invented Espo spoons. Eat your spoon.
Save the world.
I think maybe I can design app. The app will automatically calculate and categorize plastic products we use. And maybe show us how much damage they have done to the environment. The app will also set a goal for the users. How do you guys think?
Terrific, let's go into Dulac.
Hey, it's approaching lunchtime and I'm starving. Let's bring our spoons and dig in. There's something we can do.
Each bean counts.
Thank you.
第18队表演题目是 Power of Embrace, Yes We Can. 计时开始。
Hey, Emily, look at the tank top I made for myself. Isn't it gorgeous?
Emily, is something bothering you?
I'm going to transfer to another school next semester.
Wait, what?
Well, as you guys know, my family sells traditional paper cutting for a living. Yeah. But now fewer people appreciate them, so we lose our customers. And my family just couldn't afford my tuition.
But you can't leave us.
I don't want to leave either. But there's nothing I can do.
No. There must be a way to get people's attention.
How?
Wait.
No one cares about this anymore.
Oh, wait, why not combine paper cutting and fashion items?
That sounds interesting.
Right?
There must be many creative forms of paper cutting. Let's do this.
Wait, but I'm not sure if my grandpa will like this idea. He's a very traditional person.
Well, you don't know if you don't give a try. Let's go.
Welcome, kids. Make yourself comfortable.
Thank you, Grandpa. Well, so, Grandpa, I told them about my situation, and they came up with an idea that might help.
What is it?
We know paper cuttings are usually decorations on walls, but no one has ever combined them with clothes.
And just so happens that I'm really good at designing clothes. So we came up with this idea.
Nonsense. Tradition is tradition. Don't ever prevent tradition with meaningless ideas.
But Grandpa, time has changed. If we don't try to embrace these changes, we might lose what we have always held precious.
Then how are you going to prevent this from disappearing?
Well, I'm thinking of creating a YouTube channel called Power of Embrace to show how we embrace and promote different ideas so the public will notice and appreciate them.
Fine. Do what you want. I'll see if you can impress me.
You do the cutting, I do the dress.
It's amazing! I can't believe this many people commented on our channel. Ingrid, Ingrid, come look!
What?
See all these comments!
Hi, Grandpa Jimmy!
Look at this, Grandpa!
Oh, unbelievable!
We made it ourselves! We traced traditional paper cutting patterns on cloth, so the essence of the symbol can be preserved. The plum flower represents the value of endurance and strength.
Look, Grandpa, we made this for you.
Impressive.
The Chinese character, Yong Bao, represents our spirit of embracing the past and the future.
Is this my paper cutting?
Yes, Grandpa.
You really did it. Great job.
And look. We've uploaded our hard work that netizens around the world gave us positive feedback.
Look at the comments over here. This girl from India. She realized that tradition and modern creation can coexist without conflicting one another.
Here's another boy from Finland, saying that he sees value and wisdom within every unique tradition.
Yeah. We've got a voice message.
From Brazil. Your video reminds me of the declining of martial arts in a country. So I decided to film a video to turn the traditional fighting techniques into a performance like dancing. Thanks for your inspiration.
I'm so glad people are starting to care about their tradition.
Well said. I'm so proud of you kids.
Yes.
Oh, fighting techniques.
I know, dancing.
Hello? This is he. Wait, what? Sorry. I don't know any Jason Wu.
Oh, Grandpa. Jason Wu, the famous Taiwanese designer.
Oh, I know.
You know him, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Michelle Obama?
Yes. That's my granddaughter's video.
He's famous.
You want us to work with you next season? Thank you so much.
This idea actually works. Yeah, this channel is building a bridge connecting people around the world.
Indeed, small actions can lead to great impact.
Together, we accept challenges and stay competitive in this fast-changing world.
Power and embrace! Yes, we can!
Thank you.
The 19队表演题目是 What's Behind the Veil?计时开始。
Good morning.
First, let's take a look at the breaking news. France's highest administrative court has suspended a ban on full-body burgundy swimsuits that was imposed in the town on the Mediterranean coast.
Next, a teenager with German-Iranian citizenship has shot and killed 9 people and wounded more than 15 at a shopping mall in Munich, Germany. His motive was completely unclear.Said the Munich police chief. However, he suggested that there is some evidence of an Islamist or a terrorist motive.
More investigations are underway.
Morning, Florence.
Hey, morning, Danny. Did you see the news yesterday?
I did.Why?
You probably saw the news of ISIS, didn't you?
Oh yeah, of course I did. I just visited Munich this summer. I can't believe this happened. Don't they have sympathy? It was a nightmare.
Yeah, it was.
Well,
Who is she? A new classmate?
Yeah, the teacher told us earlier that there will be a Muslim student coming to our class.
She's going to be in the same class with us? No way!
Why are you so overreacting? She might be a nice girl.
Hi, my name is Florence and she's Jenny. We're your classmates.
Hello, nice to meet you. I'm Zena from Kuwait.
Why are you wearing a veil?
Oh, this is called a hijab. We always dress appropriately to show our respect and obedience to our religion. Moreover, as the Quran says...
Oh, I think I got it. Something came up. I have to go. See you around.
Hey, Jenny! Sorry, she's too paranoid.
That's okay. Many people do misunderstand us.
So sorry.
Hey, wait. You know what? Today is our fast-breaking festival, and I would like to invite you to my home for celebration. Are you free after school?
Yes, I am, but...
Come on, it won't take you too long.
Well, okay.
That's great. You can sit here or look around if you like.
Okay.
I've got something to do. I'll see you around.
Sure. I must be crazy. I should have accepted the invitation.
The buns are ready.
Got it.
The buns are ready. Oh my God, I have to find a place to hide.
Florence, what are you doing here?
Please don't hurt me, please.
What are you talking about, sweetie? You don't look well. What happened?
I saw the news yesterday, which was reporting the attack of ISIS. I'm scared that you'll attack me as well.
That's ridiculous. When since you're Muslims, we'll never be mean and hurt people.
Yeah, it's true that some members of ISIS are Muslims, but that doesn't mean every Muslim in the world is a member of ISIS.
Really?
Of course not. In fact, hurting people is the last thing that a true Muslim will do. According to the Quran, Muslims are forbidden to kill any creatures or commit suicide. We disagree with ISIS behavior and also very upset about what they did.
Oh, so I misunderstand it. Hey, I have another question. Why are Muslim women always wearing veils?
Oh, Muslim women wear veils in order not to be overexposed. And it is a way that we show respect to ourselves physically. As a matter of fact, veils actually represent our identity, and we're proud of it.
Wow.
In addition, have you ever seen a bikini? It's a type of swimsuit. The suit covers the whole body except the face, the hands, and the feet, so that we women can go swimming without violating Islamic traditions. It is unfortunate that some French people want to ban on wearing it.
I saw it on the news. Some French officials have said the ban on the outfit was a response to growing concerns about Islamic terrorism.
As you can see, we Muslims are friendly, hospitable, and peace-loving.
I totally agree with you. I'm sorry that I was ignorant and silly.
It's totally okay. We are really happy that we can have this opportunity to get to know each other and be friends. You are more than welcome to bring more friends to join us. Now, is everybody hungry?
Yeah!
Let's eat.
I finally realized how narrow-minded I used to be. We teenagers should discard stereotypes and bias by being curious and appreciative of different cultures. Well,
let's embrace the world with a great diversity.
Thank you.
The 20队 表演题目是 Feels and Peace in the Music Box. 计时开始。
哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒。Oh, hey, Oceana.
Hi.
You look tired.
Yeah.
Well, this coffee is for you.
Gracias, Fibicino.
Wow, you're such a hardworking marine conservation volunteer.
And what a barista you are.
Thank you.
Wow, it smells so great.
Here, this is for you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, by the way, guys, I have a DJ competition tomorrow.
Look,
can you guys come?
Oh, yes, of course.
I'll be there, man.
Oh, and how about inviting Al Jia?
No.
Why not?
You know, that guy's just so...
Alana, Ole, it's missing.
That guy's just so weird.
Me?
Oh, yeah, you're always making noises.
What are you making?
Hey, this is my masterpiece, but I gotta get something.
Hey, let's go check it out.
Hey, look, gears.
Electric wires. If he comes back with a timer, he must be making a time bomb. Oh my God.
Hey, guys, I got my timer.
Timer.
No.
International DJ competition, 9 p.m. at Brown Sugar Disco Pub. Ha, that's my chance.
Wow, we're finally here at the Brown Sugar Disco Pub. I'm so excited.
Yeah, and we're here to witness a DJ superstar rising tonight.
Okay. Just wait and see how I rock the world with my music. Now, let's see. Microphones, check. My mascot, check.
Wow.
And my disc, cracked. How can I create my mix without the nostalgic melody of Yuqi?
Then what should we do?
Hey guys, you're actually here.
Why are you here?
I saw your invitation card, but what's wrong with him?
Oh, JJ Dino's disc is cracked. And without it, he can't complete his nostalgic melody.
Nostalgic melody?
Hey,
then what about?
I'm
playing the Wu melody with my music box.
Wu?
Yeah. Wu is our traditional musical instrument in the Middle East. It represents the love of the father who lost his son and lamented by making his son's skeleton a stringed instrument.
I think maybe this melody could work.
I knew it. Good luck.
Okay.
Your turn.
Go. Hi everyone, I'm Jay Dino. The DJ came from Taiwan. And today, I'm gonna rock all your bodies with a cool transition that I made. This. Over here. Oh, hey, thanks, Al Jia Jia. I know I can make it without you.
No worries, DJ Champion. I really feel honored that Wu Melody could help you.
I used to think that only Yueqing can well express the subtle touch of nostalgia.
Yeah. I really feel it the minutes I listen to your CD, you play a hustle.
Really?
This tells so much about strong bond between Taiwanese people and your hometown.
Wow, and I just can't believe Wu can achieve that similar feeling.
Of course.
Hey guys, we're leaving this place, and I had a great time with you.
Yeah, and I'm packed with so many wonderful memories.
Yeah, I'm packed with the smell of your coffee and a passion for marine life.
And a new vision.
And with an open heart.
And open eyes.
Oh, and we're going to explore many other places.
How about visiting my hometown to learn making Arabic coffee?
And save the Caspian Sea, you
can. Cool. And for me as a DJ, I'll promote world peace by mixing different tunes from different cultures.
And I'm going to let my fellow countrymen to feel the peace Yueqing can bring with my music box. Take it.
Thank you.
And fulfilled our dreams.
Thank you. Oh, it's Yueqing.
Yeah.
This is my favorite melody.
It's Ocean Blue. I love it.
Oh, Al Jia Jia, I got something in my mind.
Come on, show us.
Okay.
Arabic coffee smells so great.
So great.
Caspian volunteer sounds so great.
So great.
Wu and Yueqing make my day. Wherever we are, always be convinced that fusion and peace will coexist.
Thank you.
第二十一队表演题目是 A Mission Against Free Will， 计时开始。
Alexa，
Alexa!
Oh, hey, Grandpa! It's so good to see you! I need some cash.
Again? What for?
Oh, you know, my phone is kind of old. I need a new one.
No, no, no. It's still working.
Oops! Not anymore.
Maybe you should be more careful next time.
Oh, come on, Grandpa. Just give me some cash.
No, I will not give you.
Please, Grandpa, just give me some cash.
Not this time.
Please.
I said no. I will not give you money. This time, you should work for it. You will get the money after you complete this mission. And you just go to India.
What? India? Why do I have to go to India?
Alexa, Alexa, just go there and complete the mission, or you will never get my money.
Oh. Okay, I'm in India now. Oh, what's the smell? Let's see what Grandpa wants me to do. I have to find a company called ECPC. What is ECPC anyway?
Welcome to India.
Oh gosh, you're eating your spoon?
Oh, you mean this? Oh, don't worry, it's edible. And actually, my company produced this, the Edible Cutlery Producing Company, or you can say ECPC.
ECPC? Oh gosh, you're exactly what I'm looking for. You said you own the company, right?
Yeah, I'm the founder, and my name is Bina.
And my name's Alexa. Can I go visit your factory?
Sure, why not?
Let's go.
This way.
Yes, I found ECPC. One step closer to finish the mission.
Oh, here we are.
So, this is your factory. And how do you produce your edible cutlery?
Want to know how? I'll tell you. ECPC. I have some millet. I have some wheat. Edible cutlery. Want to try?
The point is, why do you produce those? You know the plastic ones are cheaper and no one will buy your edible cutlery.
In time, will I see, it's more eco-friendly.
Aha! I know! You India people are just too poor and hungry all the time and have to eat everything as you can, including the spoon.
Excuse me, young lady. How can you say that?
Jeez, I was only joking.
You're being so rude, young lady.
Hey, Bina.
Oh, Swifa! I don't have time for you. Yes?
I have bring you some millet.
Oh, it smells great and is in good quality. I'll pay you 1,000 rupees for this.
1,000 rupees? Oh, I worked so hard, but another guy just asked to buy my stuff for only 2 rupees. Oh, you're such a fair person.
Yeah, I believe in fair trade.
Fair trade? That's right. She worked so hard, but the other guy only paid her 2 rupees. That's so unfair.
By the way, everyone in our farm uses your edible cutlery, and it reduces a lot of unnecessary plastic.
That's because my company aims to make the world more eco-friendly.
Eco-friendly? So that's why Bina produced this edible cutlery. Oh gosh, I was so wrong. I should go apologize.
Oh, I have to go. See you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bina?
Yeah?
Look, about earlier, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have insulted you and your country.
That's okay. Maybe it's just because you didn't understand in the beginning.
So, am I forgiven now?
Of course, I forgive you.
Well, I think your edible cutlery is actually quite cool. I think I can introduce this to Taiwan.
Oh, really? That's wonderful!
Well, but there's one problem, though. I don't think the people in Taiwan can accept this kind of flavor.
That's okay. We can create other flavors good for Taiwanese.
Hey, Grandpa, I'm back.
Oh, Alexa, how was your journey in India?
Oh, it was great. I learned a lot of things, like
at cultures and I learned to look at things in different perspectives. Oh, here. It's the edible pottery from ECPC. It's eco-friendly and it's a fair trade and very delicious. Here, try it.
Oh, it's the taste of Tony's flavor, chou doufu. How comes?
Oh, because I suggested bina to make a flavor that's more common in Taiwan.
It seems like you change a lot, Alexa.
Yeah, that's because I have learned and I have shared and made many new friends.
You're now a real diplomat.
Yeah, this is all because of you, Grandpa. Thank you, you're the best.
Namaste.
第二十二对表演题目是 A Gift， 计时开始。
Mom, look, what is it about?
It's about the exchange program. I can learn so much in America.
Oh, really? Let me take a look. 1 million? That's ripoff. Why not go to the Philippines? You can also learn English there.
Oh, Mom.Can you imagine how messed up my accent would be?
Hey, don't judge people like that. That's not nice of you.
Mom, you haven't even been there. Oh, I've been dreaming about it for my whole life.
Your whole life? All right, if that's your dream, I'll support you. But promise me that you always know what you're doing and be nice to everyone.
Thanks! Deal, Mom!
An American adult. Besides, I found the more we try to be like them, the more they belittle our culture.
To be honest, I used to think we are the best, but it is you guys that told me those fascinating cultures of your countries.
Wow! I didn't know how amazing my culture is until you told me. And Malie, sorry that I used to judge about where you're from. Will you tell me more about Thai culture?
Yeah, sure, but let's get some food first.
Okay.
How are you?
Hi, Mom. I'm doing
New York.
Hello.
So, how do you girls spend your time together?
Molly cooked the suntan for us last week.
That was nothing, but I was really impressed by the bubble tea Eva made us. That was awesome.
Wow, sounds great. So,
Mom, I gotta hang up. We are going to a concert later. Well, see ya. I love ya.
Love you too. Have fun.
Bye.
Bye.
Time flies. I gotta go back to Taiwan. Mom, our school is going to host an exchange student from the Philippines. Can we volunteer?
Being a host family is not easy as you think. Will you be able to deal with all the problems?
My exchange life experienced things that only exchange students would understand, such as culture shock, racial discrimination, and doubt about our identity. If we host her, I can definitely help.
That makes sense.
I remember saying the only gift I would get is to improve my English, but I have totally changed my mind after knowing Mali and Jenny.
Oh, I'm so glad that you've grown a lot in America. You're blessed to have those friends.
I know. Now I think our friendship is the best gift I got this year.
Yeah, the best gift.
1, 2, 3. Thank you.
第二十三对表演题目是 Dance on the Global Stage， 计时开始。
Grandpa, Grandpa, Hey, Grandpa,、have you seen Thai Cam Style?
Thai Cam Style? What's that?
Oh, come on, Grandpa, you're old-fashioned. See?
Wow, you say.Thai what?
Thai Cam, Thai for Taiwan, and Cam for Cambodia.
A mixture of Cambodian and Taiwanese elements?
Yeah, and also mixing contemporary and traditional dance. See, millions of likes.
Wow, but who'd make this?
Not sure, but let me Google it.
I want to tell this to Grandma.
Okay.See you, Grandpa.
Where are you, honey?
Thai Cam creator? Oh, I got it. One of the dancers in Taiwan named Jason.
Jason!
I'm having a dance audition in New York.
Yes.
Really? Congratulations.
So where are you guys going for the summer?
London, the Palace of Dance.
Oh, yeah!
Awesome! How about you guys?
Cambodia!
Cambodia?
What's that?
It's an exchange program.
Exchange program?
Yeah, the Cambodian government invited us there.
We are invited.
But contemporary dance in the US?
Check! Contemporary dance in the UK?
Check! But contemporary dance in Cambodia?
Southeast Asia?Come on!
It's ridiculous! No! We can teach them, right?
Yeah, Cambodians will love it! I promise!
But in Cambodia, it was not what they thought.
What a waste of my time! I still have a rehearsal tonight!
Yeah!I do not understand why the government wants us to learn this contemporary dance. Whatever dance.
So you're the one going to teach us?
Yeah.
No, thanks.
No.
Let me tell you, we already have traditional dances we're proud of.
Calm down. Excuse him for his bad temper. Calm down. We can show them.
Okay, let's show them.
Don't you
something's awesome, we need to preserve it.
Traditional dance.
Traditional dance. Tradition means everything to us. So you are not going to make any change.
Of course not. So take your modern or whatever dance back.
No, actually, traditional dance is indeed wonderful.
Of course.
But our contemporary dance is beautiful as well. Let's show them. Idea. Why don't we mix them together?
That's right. So we can mix them together into a jazzy new dance.
Get it.
So is your dance like this?
Yeah. And how about your traditional dance? Like this?
Yes.
So we can call the new dance Thai Kim style.
As we mix Taiwanese elements
and Cambodian elements. Oh, I got it. Maybe this new dance will come out well.
Yeah. So we can preserve your traditional elements.
As we combine them with creative modern moves.
Yes!
That makes sense. I suppose it might be good.
Yes, let's tell them!
Let's go!
Back in Taiwan, it was not just good.
Jason, your exchange program really started a new trend.
Yeah, see? Everyone in the world is dancing.
Wow, our stereotype was so wrong.
Yeah, being international is not just about going to famous developed countries.
It includes every single nation.
All are equally of value.
Yes, and talking about countries, where are you guys going for the winter vacation? Republic of Fiji.
Middle East.
Mongolia.
We are ready for anywhere
with you on the global stage.